Kathy, thanks for spending a little time with us today. You've done so much for our reunion. Without you, it would not have happened. And we've been excited to pilot with you on the Edina Alum Program. We're hoping you can share with us a little bit about what it's like to be a student today at Edina and share with us a little bit more about the nonprofit.
Welcome. This is your first glimpse of what Edina High School looks like right now. In 2022. It is a little different. We're in the Commons. You probably can see some familiarity here. We still got our backdrop of current jam, which is awesome. The floor is not brick anymore, but we do have this lovely red brick over here that used to cover our floors. We've got thick auditorium as it used to be. Now we get to actually see outside more than we've ever done before in our Commons. Edina has two mission-aligned partners, one of which is Edina Education Fund, the other is Edina Give and GO, and you'll learn more about those on your actual tour day. But to give you a glimpse of what it is that we do, first of all, state and federal taxes alone cannot fund the Edina excellence that you and I grew up with. I myself am an Edina grad, and I know that things were very different when we were in school. Right around the early to mid-1990s, the expenses that public schools nationwide were experiencing were expanding at a rate much higher than the revenue was coming in from state and federal dollars. So what happens there is we need to make up that difference. And there's two different ways that Edina chooses to do this, one of which is within the school day. And that's where the Edina Education Fund steps in. We provide funding to the schools in three different areas: in literacy, in STEAM, and in mental health and wellness. Our foundation provides funding for anything from our writing center that is right behind me and our STEM learning center in our high school, offering tutoring 7 days a week from before school till after school and in the evenings at our libraries throughout the city of Edina, making sure that our kids have what they need to excel in the classroom. To things like Edina Unified Programming for our special ed kids to work with our general education kids, to bridge that gap, to stop asking what can't you do and start asking what can we do, and most importantly, what can we do together. Also programming like our really exciting STEAM programming that's coming up this fall that we wouldn't be able to do with tax dollars alone, and it's called the SSCP, the Student Space Flight Experiments Program, where we will actually be conducting experiments and having our students work in teams from fifth grade through 12th grade to present proposals of science experiments, the winner of which will be launched on Mission 17 to the International Space Station next spring. So funding to the Edina Education Fund this year from the class of 82, you could say, would be helping to send one of our student experiments literally to space. These are really exciting programs. They offer things like mental health in the schools. We've got therapists in every single building here to help our kids with anything from anxiety and depression to chemical dependency issues to food nutrition issues. All of that is covered by the Edina Education Fund. Outside of our school day, we rely on our partner Edina Give and GO to step in and help our kiddos that need a little bit extra outside the school day, be it in athletics, academics, or the arts. Maybe you've got a sixth grader, and every sixth grader should be able to play soccer. Well, that has a fee associated with it. And that's where Edina Give and GO can step in and pay that fee to make sure that that kiddo feels included as part of our general community.
Okay, hi. Now I'm here with Mary Munson-Lokowicz. Mary was actually the classmate behind this whole effort. She really wanted our class to have an opportunity not only to see the school, but also to give back to the community, obviously giving back to the students and giving them that extra help to make it in this world. Mary, can you tell us what you'd like to see the rest of the classmates do on Saturday morning?
Well, first and foremost, I'm just really excited and hopeful that all of you will show up and take a tour of this amazing school. It has changed so much from the time we graduated in 82. I know it's taken on a couple huge remodels, but it's such a beautiful space. And I'd love if all of you came and took a tour, looked around and see all the, again, amazing things that's going on here in the school and opportunities for the legacy of Edina. And then, yes, I'm passionate about giving our time, talent, treasure. As Kristen and I both know, my mother, our wonderful Girl Scout leader, taught us the importance of giving, volunteering, of sharing our time and our talents and treasures with others. So on that note, I would love it if you could either donate or bring something for either Edina Ed Foundation or Edina Give and GO. If you would love to go buy a backpack, either a drawstring one or a sturdy backpack that has a protective cover for laptops, and then fill it of everything students need, from pencils, pens, markers, watercolors, earbuds, earphones, all of it. Fill it up and bring it. We'd love to be able to give that to Edina Give and GO as a gift from our class 1982. So see you Saturday morning, 10 a.m.
And be ready to donate, class. Let's always leave a bigger footprint behind.